Welcome back, everybody. Yes, we're in Ash Lake, and if you watched previous episodes, we already killed the Hydra and already searched around this area. I'm going to go ahead and show you a little secret in this. Let's see, the Hydra was back there, and he is now dead. There's another tree as you run down this long beach shoreline, and I've already killed everything inside it. I just wanted to show you a little secret that I was trying to figure out and just ran across it, really. So there's a couple of little cursed demons in here, cursed froggies, and the large mushroom head here, which you don't really have to fight, but you know, if you kill him, you kill him, whatever. He's just a pain in the ass, it takes a long time. So anyway, the only way out of here is through this little tunnel here. And if you look up there, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a little cave, alcove, and you can come out there on top of the mushrooms where there's an item. But there's no indication of how actually to get there. And watch out, this is a little tricky. You might slip off the edge, and it's happened before. So you come out here, and there's one more cursed demon here. But take a look down there. Take a look down. I don't know if you can see it. There's a broken log down there. I'll try to get to the edge so I can show you. See down there? So you can actually drop down there. You got to be very careful you don't like run off the edge or something. But you basically just manipulate, and there you go. So now you're in this log, and everything looks cool, and, so yeah. Oh, I look badass. Look at that sword. So good. Anyways. So then, yeah, make your way up here. It's a little slippery, so you gotta run a little hard. Get your footing down. And, you come out where you saw the alcove, and there's a dead body up here, and it has a glowy on it, and you pick it up, and it's a really, really high-powered barrier spell. You definitely want to get it, it's just one of those things that you don't want to pass by. So anyway, that's that. And that took me a while to figure out, because I was running around this tree, I was looking up and down, I was looking for roots to climb, and I just couldn't see a damn thing. So, you know what, I hope that shed some light and people don't have to like freak out about it and think they missed something. It's one of those things you don't want to miss. And also here, we're going to run down here to the stone, I guess a stone dragon. And most of you have obviously already chosen to covet with him, which is good because you get some pretty good items. But if you come around here, and I searched this place and I was wondering what was going on here. And he's got a really big bushy tail here. See that old bushy tail? Now cut that tail off, okay? Don't worry, it's not going to do anything. He's not going to initiate a battle or anything. It's just kind of like one of those things, random. And you can get an item from him. And it's the Dragon Greatsword. And it's pretty freaking sweet. So, there's a little tricky little item that I don't think a lot of you knew about either. So, hopefully that helps. Don't worry, you can still pray to the Covenant, you can still do all the Covenant stuff, it doesn't change a thing. You just now have a Dragon Greatsword. So let's go ahead here and show you what it looks like. I got so many swords, I got so much stuff. There we go, Dragon Greatsword. Heck of a lot of damage. Obviously I can't use it right now. It's 40 strength. I do not have that. Yeah, 40 strength. So anyway, that's it. I know it's a little dark. Can't really see it. But I'll try to get to some lighting and show you. Anyway, it's like all encrusted in stuff. definitely cannot wield it. But anyways, hope that shed some light on two little secrets. Enjoy.